Hello everyone, welcome to Friend and Fun. So today we are going to create pure CSS loader using HTML and CSS. Okay, so this is my index.html, my style.css and my style.css. So it is having some variables here and a custom Google font. So I'm using background and some yellow color, white color. I'm using the variable for a cube size and for the easing time and the duration here and then iteration. Okay, so we are not interested in the script file. Fine, so let's get started by writing a div with a class of loader, and inside this we'll be having a div with a class of cube. Inside this cube we'll be having side, so actually 6 sides. So here I'll be using just 5 sides, and inside each side we'll be having a span element. Okay, so this is the markup. So let's quickly jump to style.acss and start styling this element. So for safety I'm adjusting the box sizing property of all the elements to border box, and we'll target the cube, and I'll include a cube mix in here, okay, which I'll be creating 100 pixel. So I'll be creating a cube mix in mix in cube. So I'm just giving the default value here, height 100 pixel. Fine. First we'll start with the cube mixing. Okay, so initially let's give it a height of dollar height. So I want the height and width of this cube to be equal. So this is a perfect square, that is the reason I'm using height and width as the same values here. Okay, let me add some border here, border 1 pixel solid. So as you can see, this is our cube. So first let's center the cube. So I'll target the loader, and because we want the loader to be centered, I'm setting the position of this element to absolute. Top 0, bottom 0, left 0, right 0. Set the margin to auto. I'll display the element as flex, justify content to center, align items to center. Okay, and I'll be writing a message, so I'm setting the flex direction to column. Fine, so as you can see we are having the cube at the center. Fine, next we'll target the cube mix in. So inside the cube mix in we have set the height and width of this element. So we'll make the transform style to preserve 3D, because we want to create a 3D effect. We'll set the position to relative, and I'll apply transform on this element so that when I change the angles of the sides, you'll be able to see it clearly. Okay, fine. So this is the angle of the cube. Next we are having a sides here. So I'll target the side inside the mixin, and let's give it a height of dollar height and width of dollar height, and set the position to absolute. So I'll target the side inside this. So whatever style I want to apply, whether it is a background or a border color, I'll be applying inside the cube. I'll not touch inside the cube mix in here. Okay, so I'll give it a border of one pixel solid red. So if I zoom, as you can see all the elements are, sides are in red border. Okay, so we'll set the top 0, bottom 0, left 0, right 0, and set the margin to auto, display the element as flex, justify content to center and align items to center. The reason I am making the side as display as flex because we are having a span element inside the side, so I want to make the span element centered. That is the reason I am applying the display here. Okay, transform style to preserve 3D. Next we'll target individual elements, so and colon n child of 1. So I'm targeting this side with n child of 1. Okay, so I'll apply transform on this element, rotate it via x minus 90 degrees and translate the element via z dollar height divided by 2. Okay, so as you can see the side is positioned at the bottom. Similarly, I'll apply transforms on this all the elements and make them appear as a cube. So and colon n child of 2, we'll apply transform and translate the element via z minus dollar height by 2. Okay, so I have positioned the second one at the left corner. Okay, similarly I'll target the nth child of 3 and we have pushed the element towards left. Similarly, we are going to push the element towards right. So I'll apply transform, rotate the element via y 180 degrees and translate it via z minus dollar height by 2. Okay, so we have pushed this towards the right. Similarly, we'll apply rotate on the other two elements and make them sit on the that side and this side. Okay, opposite corners, and colon n child of 4, we'll apply transform, rotate the element via y 90 degrees and translate the element via z negative height by 2. Okay, so we are just the last one, and colon n child of 5, transform, rotate the element via y minus 90 degrees and translate it via z dollar height by 2. Okay, so this is our cube and these are the sides here. Fine, so we are done with the sides. Next let's target the span. So we are having a span element inside each side, so we'll target the span element, set the position to absolute, top 0, bottom 0, left 0, right 0, set the margin to auto and transform margin to bottom. Because I want to rotate it via bottom, I am applying the transform margin to bottom. Okay, the transform style will be preserve 3D, and let's give it a border of 2 pixels solid. Okay, I'll target the border color here. So inside the span yellow. Fine, so as you can see these are the span elements and we are having the sides and span elements. So let's get rid of the border on the cube. So I'll get rid of the border on the cube. Fine, next we'll add the animation for this. So I'll make use of @thread keyframes and span animate. So this is the animation for the span elements, and transform, rotate it via x 0 degrees to 90, 100%. Transform, rotate it via x 180 degrees. Okay. Next, we'll make the animation for cube also. So @thread keyframes, cube animate. So I want to make the cube translate via y-axis. So I'll just apply from and transform, rotate the element via x 30 degrees. I'm just preserving these values. So rotate it via y minus 45 degrees and translate it via y-axis 0 to, I'll just make a copy of this and translate the y position to cube size. So the cube size is 100 pixel, so we'll just apply the 100 pixel cube size instead of the 100 pixel inside the mixin. Okay, fine. So we'll apply this animation to the elements. For that, first let me change the background color of the span elements. Set the background color to linear gradient. So I'll apply the gradient from yellow to darken color of the yellow 10%. Okay, we'll get rid of this border on this side element. Next, after this I'll make use of a for loop. So I want the animation to be applied from 2 to 5, that is n child of 2 to n child of 5. I don't want to apply the animation on the first element. So for that, $i from 2 through 5 dot side colon n child of hash $i span animation span animate the time, the timing and the iteration. Okay, so as you can see we are having a cool effect. Next, we'll target the cube. So inside the cube, I'll just add the animation cube animate timing and iteration. So this is a cool effect. Okay, let's add a message here. So I'll set it. So inside this loader, we'll just write a message. So I'll be writing a div with class of message. Inside this, getting things ready, please wait. Okay, we'll target the message inside the loader and set the font size to rem 24 pixel and margin top. So we want the gap between the load cube as well as the content. So I'm just giving a high margin value. The color will be dollar yellow and text transform to uppercase, text align to center. Okay, so let's apply the font we have imported on the top. So for that I'll just use font family and the final thing is we'll apply color to the body. Okay, so after my mixing I'll target the body, set the background color to our background. Okay, so that's it. Here is the cool animation. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please do watch other videos on my channel. Please share and subscribe. I'll provide the source code at fundandfun.com. You can find the link in description below. We'll meet again in an exciting tutorial. Take care.